Meet Russia's new Su-75 Checkmate, next generation unmanned stealth fighter. Will Russia actually build these stealth fighter jets, or will they stay stuck on the drawing board forever like so many of their other military ideas? Su-75 Checkmate aircraft at the Dubai Air Show. Officials from Russia's Sukhoi Design Bureau offered up bottles of a limited edition Checkmate perfume. No fragrance, however, will mask how the Su-75 isn't a light tactical fighter, as advertised. During a Moscow air show, Russia rolled out a mock-up of the Su-75, a multi-purpose fighter bomber designed to compete in the global marketplace. The actual fighter, the Su-75, does indeed have some promise. The single engine makes for a fast airplane at Mach 1.8. The engine enables a range of at least 1,700 miles with a ceiling of 40,000 feet. The stealthiness is helped by an internal weapons bay and a hybrid wing body with a V-shaped tail. The weapons are what you'd expect from a fifth-generation fighter, a 7-ton collection of air-to-air and air-to-surface missiles, including anti-ship missiles. The Russians claim the warplane can engage and destroy several targets at once. Unmanned Wingman in play. The Checkmate may have an unmanned version. It could also potentially control several drones at once, as the video shows what appears to be unmanned aircraft. This is likely the Hunter S-70 stealth drone. It would be a significant capability for the Checkmate, if it could indeed be tethered to the S-70 unmanned system. The Hunter, or Akhutnik in Russian, can fly at 600 miles per hour and weighs a hefty 20 tons, making it one of the biggest drones in the world. The flying wing shape is supposed to make it stealthy. The Russians can arm it or use it for intelligence, surveillance, and reconnaissance. It also has the capacity to serve as an airborne command and control craft or as a bomber. Su-75 Checkmates and Hunter would be a valuable collaboration. It's possible the Checkmate could be integrated with the S-70 drone. The Russians have 5 years until the planned production date, so this could be doable. The Americans have a drone Wingman too. The ever-loyal Wingman is an interesting concept. The United States has its own drone Wingman called the XQ-58A Valkyrie. The Valkyrie is also stealthy and is being developed with the Skyborg artificial intelligence brain. The idea is to allow the Valkyrie to conduct targeting and reconnaissance for the F-35 and F-22 pilots so they can focus on flying and operating weapons systems. Su-75 Checkmate, will it sell to overseas customers? The first flight is planned for 2023 and it may be introduced as soon as 2026. The fighter costs only $30 million, which enabled it to draw a crowd at the recent Dubai Air Show. The Checkmate is meant for export sales to help pay for the indigenous production run. The Dubai Air Show was the first time the Checkmate has ventured out of Russia. The comparatively low price tag could make the fifth-generation airplane desirable with overseas partners. Propaganda notwithstanding, the Checkmate is something to keep an eye on. Russian aerospace industrial leaders claim that the Checkmate can be rapidly developed, mass-produced, and made available to foreign buyers later in this decade. A key assumption, though, is that the investment in the Su-57 can jumpstart the Checkmate program. But the Su-57 has been in development nearly 15 years already, and Western analysts estimate that it still won't be operational before 2027. The first operational Su-57 will be equipped with the Saturn AL-41F1 low bypass turbofan combat engine, the same engine that powers the Su-35, a heavy fighter bomber designed in the 1980s. The new engine planned for the Su-57 is not slated for production until mid-decade, if then. Can countries realistically expect that Sukhoi will do better with the Checkmate? Russian and Sukhoi marketers also say that Checkmate will be the cheapest fifth-generation fighter aircraft on the international arms market. It is difficult to imagine that the Su-57 production problems aren't going to require major investments, and that inevitably will drive up the price for Checkmate, too. Given how far the Su-57 production schedule has slipped, the prospect that the Su-75 will be available for foreign customers by 2030, especially if foreign air forces begin placing orders. Until then, we are likely to see more Russian videos in social medias. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe.